Hello everyone, welcome you all. Today I am going to discuss about the data tables concept in Cucumber framework series. So this is going to be a very useful and very informative session because we have different approaches to use this data tables. So I will be showing you some of them, like as a list concept and as a maps concept. So and before we begin to this actual data tables, so we need to understand what is the difference between the scenarios outline and the data tables. So in the scenarios outline, we need to use the example keyword. So using that example keyword, we can retrieve the data from the feature file and we can pass to the step definition. But using the data table, so no need to use any additional keywords in the feature file, but we can handle using some extra code. So I will be showing that stuff now. So we will be having more than one approach to see all the as list and as maps. So how can we retrieve the data from the feature file to the step definitions? So let's get started. In case if you are new to my channel, please do subscribe to my channel. Let me open my Eclipse IDE. So this is a project that we are using for as part of Cucumber framework series, right? So in the last session, we have discussed about the feature file scenarios outline. So this is a session that we have discussed in the last session. So in case if you are new to this session, do watch that session so that you will understand the difference between the scenarios outline and the data tables. So let me copy this same feature file. So I wanted to use the same feature file, and let me open the scenarios test scenarios 3.feature. So I don't need these examples now because we are not using any keywords here, and I don't need parameterization here. So I will be removing from the parameterization now, right? So I will be adding one more, like in the line only I'm adding some extra information, like user enter username password in login page, right? And now, so here only I need to pass some more parameters, or we can say the test data that we are going to enter into our step definitions. So to enter that, so we'll be following the syntax here. So the pipe symbol, so this will acts like a array or matrix kind of, like we are using 2x2 matrix or 1 matrix or 3x3 matrix. So it will be on matrix base, like how we use in the arrays concept. So arrays were 2-dimensional array, 3-dimensional array. So generally we are like 2-dimensional array we are using now. So test user and the password is pass, and this is the data that I wanted to enter into my login page. So the Facebook login page which we demonstrated earlier, right? So I'm using the same approach here now. So let me do a pretty format and quickly run as the feature file, because after running the feature file only you can see one extra step definition that's going to be generated. So we will be using that step definition now. We will be running as this feature file now. So this session will fail. So this will be failing that to login, but we will be getting one method which is the step definition that been missing. Right, so let me close this browser, automated browser. So here in the console you can see there is one extra step definition that was missing, so that it is asking to implement this snippet here. So let me copy this and let's go to the step definition file which we have created earlier. So we'll be going to use the same step definition here. So I wanted to use the step definition. So you can see the difference between the previous scenarios outline example and non-data table example. So in this, so we are using different approaches, like list approach, and we have map approach, and list approach, and list of map approach, and map approach. So all this we are going to use now using the data tables, right? So now let me remove the data extra commented code, and we will be importing the data table. Let me import the data tables. So this is the one you need to import. Import data table io.cucumber data table, right? Once you import, let's now start beginning. So we will be using this name locators. So I will be using the same code here now. So using the data tables, so this is the data table. So using the data table, I wanted to represent entire data as a form of list. So I will be using as list. So we will be using the list of list concept here. So representing list with another list concept. So we'll be using that here, and end with semicolon. So we are passing every data in the form of strings, right? So let me use the string dot class. So we can use the object type as well. So in case if you wanted to use the object type, you can use the object type so that it will handle all the types in the test data. So this is of list type, right? So let me import the list here. So this is a list of list items. So let me use one more list item here, and we are passing the data in the form of strings. Check string, and I need to provide a reference here so that it will be picked up from there. So I am using now list of list concept using the as list concept of data tables. Now using this data, so here we are using the same locators, right? Enter username, password, using the send keys. So I will be passing this data here dot get. So we will be using the index based approach. So we are using a two dimensional array of representation, right? So this is a 0th index and 0th of 0 and 0.1. So 0 of 0, 1 and 0, 0 test data user. So I will be using the same approach here. So let's take this 0th index, and in the 0th index, my data is at the 0th index again. So get, again it's a 0. Similarly for passwords, so password is at the 0 and 1. 0.0, 1 position. So I need to take data dot get index. Let me select it. It's loading. Right, 0. And again, I need to locate under 0th row. I need to select my first column. Right, for first column represent with 1. So save. So this is a simple code that you can use for this indexed based approach using the array list as array list. So quickly save this step definition, and you can run from either feature file or you can run from a runner class. So this is a runner class, and now currently it is pointed to the feature file 3. So let me quickly go as run as JUnit now. So we are not using any parameterization here, and without using the examples. So data will be picked up from the feature file, and now you can see the data is being entered here. Right, obviously this session will be failing because we are using the invalid username passwords. Right, so this is how it will be picking the data from the feature file. So the feature file data is here, and the username password that we are entered from there. So what if I wanted to use more than one data set? So I wanted to use more than one data set, or I wanted to use some header based approach. So I wanted to use the approach of headers. So how can we do that? Now we'll see. Now so till now we have used the list with using index space, right? So now what I will do, I will go to my feature file now. So what I will do, I will now consider this test user and password as my headers. So under that headers, I need to represent my test data. So under that, if I have one data set or two data set, a representation of using this header. So if I call the header, it should pick my data in my list. So here I will be adding one. So demo user one, and my password is test 123, right? So I will be saying this as username. Right, let me do a PT format now. Yeah, so these are my headers. So now these are my headers. So under that header, so this data I should pick from here. I need to push it to the step definition where it will again push it to my browser. Right, so now I will be using some small correction here. So you can see here it is being represented here, right, with a list of list. Now what I will do, I will not use this now. I will be using with a map, right, using the map. How can I do that? So using data table again, data table dot. So here we can represent many formats here. So you can use the as map with a list, so list with as map. So I need to pick this. So here you can see the implementation method, like as maps list, under list you have again map with string. I need to select this, right? And here I need to pass two strings because we are using two dimensional, right? So string, again I need to use one more string dot class. it end with semicolon. Now, so this is on the list with map, right? So I need a reference to represent it. So again, go to the starting and using the list. So Java utils dot list, and again I need to pick the map again. So we are using the headers concept, right? So to pick the headers, we need a key and value pair. So K and V represent key and value, right? It's a string, both are string again, right? And here I will say list data, right? List data equal to, this is my, the line I need to use here. So this line represents a list of maps. So all the maps using key and value pair, because the key representing the header here, right? And the value is inside it. So now using the list data, so I don't want to use this here now, the previous approach. Now I will be using the list data, or for your reference, what I will do, I'll comment these two lines so that you will have a reference of what we are using next. Let me uncomment again. Let me copy paste. Right, and let me comment these two lines again. So now using this list data reference, so I need to change the data fetching details, right? So list data dot get. So now get using the map approach, right? So it will be providing the map string of string, right? Get 0th index and dot, again use the get. Now you can see it is providing the object key. So we need to pass the key so that data from that key will be fetched. So my key will be, so what kind of key that it has representing in the feature file. So this is a username, right? So that we need to provide here. So we need to provide in this format, which is a string format. So similarly, I need to use for password as well, right? Get off again here, I need to provide the key value. So the key is password. Right, so now using this approach, so now we are representing the headers. So using that headers, try to pick the data from the list, right? Now quickly save this and go to the feature file or runner class. Now run as JUnit. Now browser session started successfully. Now we can see data is been entered, right, using the map approach. So this is how you enter the data using the list map. So we have other approach as well. Now we'll be demonstrating that. Till now we have seen using this headers approach using only one data set, right? So now I wanted to use multiple data sets. So now I will include one more user data here, user information. So I will add it at last again. So this will be my demo user, or I will say this time it is a test user, right? Test user one, and my password is same. Let me do a pretty format again and quickly save. So this time we are using the header with the two rows or more than one row, that more than one data set I wanted to use. So here I will be using the same approach. So using the enhance for loop, I will iterate the process. So for map, so for map Java utils key and value pair, so my key and value is string and it is also a string. So using a map data, so I will be representing this with the map data, and now using that list data. So list data already we have implemented, right? List data using the map, again we are taking the data tables as a maps, right? Using the same here now. So list data, right? Here I wanted to represent, it says under for loop now. So I will comment this line. So I don't want to click on this login, so that I will be demonstrating you that how can we use that. So using this map, so before that, what I will do, I will use some clear commands so that our data will be entered after one instance. So I will use clear, and similarly I will copy this password, right? So here password also I will clear, right? And now, so representation in the send keys, so I don't want to use a list approach. Now I wanted to use a map approach, so using the map data, right? Map data dot get the object. So I wanted to use now object. So what is an object that we are representing? The header, right? So which is a username. So I will be using the username here, and similarly map data, using the map data I wanted to take the passwords, right? Quickly save. So this is the map approach. So now I will go to the runner now. So runner, I will be running as JInit. Now driver started, and you can see it has entered two, demo user and test user. So using the map approach. So this is how you enter the data into that step definition from the feature file using the data tables concept. So we have many approaches in this. Under data tables, we have different approaches to utilize. So we can create object for map so that will handle any type of data that may be int type, character or string type. So every data will be handled if we are using the object type. So we are now working on the framework series, right? So we will be coming across that scenario as well. So during that session, I will be explaining more about the object type, how can we use. I hope this session is useful for you. In case if you are new to my channel, do subscribe. And please do like, share and comment. Thank you.